So what happened last week is I personally expected price to fall from here, but it didn't. And that's totally okay, because now if we get this week's selling opportunity, it's going to be more pips. So what I really like about last week was it wicked slightly above this high and ended the week with a really strong rejection. If we look at the daily, okay, this is that high that started that week. We look at the daily. This is where I thought we'd be taking shorts. I actually did enter some, then I took a little bit of a loss with a stop loss up here. And now we've entered again up here. Now when the market opens, looking to add even further positions. Well, we can see the behavior of the candles. There's not that much movement here. Lots of rejection. And then we have a huge push up. Rejection, and then a slight wick above that to stop out even more people. This wick is literally the banks taking out stop losses. And we end with a really nice pin bar, which is beautiful. Very beautiful pin bar on the daily. So the target I'm looking for is going to be the lows down here. 149 is the full target. Honestly, down here is 148.5, but pretty much 99% of the position will be closed at 149. Holding everything till then, because that's roughly 300 pips. So now that we know where the market's going to go, or we are forecasting where the market's going to go, it's time to look into where we're going to enter, where's the best place to enter. And you can use 1 hour or 4 hour. I'm gonna go ahead and like this and move this to the top of last week. Okay, so now this is as high as it'll go. What I would really love to see is price come back up into this high of this 4 hour body and potentially even just come up in here a little bit and then start rejecting and ultimately not break these highs. That's what I really want to see, is price not be able to get past above here. Or if it does, just a slight wick. I don't think it'll do that. I don't think we'll come all the way back up. But we could, and we'll be prepared for that. So the pound, yen, simply, what I see is we have this low and this high. And then we have this new lower low, and then we snap back up and take these equal highs. And if I really zoomed in on it, you can see that this is actually slightly higher. So it just slightly wicked above this one. And then we absolutely dumped super hard, right? That is a lot of pressure. That's exactly what I like to see. I don't count this as a lower low, because if we go to like 30 minute or 15 minute, the bodies of the candles actually do reach down here. However, this is a lot of sell pressure. That's why I also don't think we're gonna wick above this week's high again. I think we are gonna stay within that range. I think we just slightly pull back up to make this week's wick. And then hopefully we can see this sort of pressure off of this level once again, and that'll confirm we have enough sell pressure and the momentum is changing to the downside. We already have the lower low, we have the equal highs, the one got stopped out. So what I'd like to see is that lower high around this area, and then we could take some entries from there. And this is a daily, I'm looking at this as a daily setup. So, I mean, the swing target is 300 pips. So personally, if we get this move and we get the rejection exactly as expected, I'm not taking any partials at all. I'm holding it to full profit. This level right here, if you look at the top of this daily wick, this level also intrigues me too, because we see that a lot before our price moves kind of like right here. Right here, we we get this wick, right? This candle pull all the way back up here into the highs of this wick, and then we see the dump. So, you know, I could leave that there. Okay, let me do two lines here for you. So, because I like having a range, so I'm gonna say between these two minor levels here, this is where I personally will be placing more entries if we can come back up here and reject. The second scenario is price just keeps going down and down, and then we'll cross that bridge with the come to it. If that's the case, if price just blows past here, I would like to see it pull back up to these levels, and then we can place another entry here if we don't, you know, come all the way back up here. So let me draw that out. So we could be going like this for an entry, or we could be going like that for an entry. This one would be more ideal because obviously that's going to be a better entry point. That's like 20, 25 pips higher, which would be nice, but that's pretty much it. If we go like this, it's clear. In my eyes, this is a clear corrective structure. Once the pressure breaks this structure and we actually see it come down, whether we do that immediately or we pull back up, then we know it's really gonna happen, and we can put the right amount of risk on that to capitalize as much as possible. That's it for pound yen. Hope you guys could understand and see that very clearly. I have pound USD, which I actually have not analyzed in a while. So I'm kind of looking at the same thing here. I'm just marking up levels. We see this high of this candle and this low of this candle. And there is a lot of bullish pressure here, but it's interesting to see this week close with so much rejection. If we go on to the daily, we can see we are still bullish here. And let's go to the 4 hour. It's interesting to see the rejection happen at this specific level, the top of that weekly. Like I said, the pound pairs, they play within the weekly levels quite well. And if we can see this continue to reject over the next few 4 hour candles and stay below this on the 4 hour level, right? I don't care if like 30 minute candles come up here and come down, but like on the 4 hour and the daily, if we can continue the rejection, we could possibly sell off. And the reason is, Okay, if we ignore the blue line, we're looking at a move down, corrective structure up, wick, the previous weekly high, and then possible continuation. However, if we don't stay down here, and on the daily level, if we just keep pushing through this level, we could see a full move to the upside up into pretty much, 1.41, 1.42, right? This area right here. If we can break up and keep going up, we would look for an entry and a pullback. But the target would be in this area, probably towards the bottom of this area, because that is, you know, that's a good 200 pips. That's a pretty good amount of pips. And same with the short, 250 pips short. It's somewhat like a double bottom here. I typically like seeing, see how these wicks are below that line. I like seeing it the other way around. So we'd create pretty much just be switched for it to be a true double bottom, which leads me to believe we might actually see the fall. It just It depends on the DXY market as well. DXY can have a huge impact on all the pairs with USD in it. So if USD is strong, you might see this drop. If USD continues to be weak, that will help boost this up into these levels here. So it's just kind of waiting right now. Clear higher highs, no higher lows yet. So I'm not really biased on sells or buys right now because we are at this very strong resistance. So right now for GU personally, it's a waiting game. I want to see the structure start to change. I want to see it stay below this level or break through it, like a clear breakthrough, and then we can look for a corrective structure back down to this level before buying all the way up into these previous highs over here. So it all depends what price does. Euro, yen, I can already tell you I'm probably going to be looking to sell this just because of pound yen. So what I like seeing is this level right here. So what's up, Harsh? This dude has 1,300 pips open right now. Crazy guy. See, this level is respected right here, here, even right here, here. And now we're trying to respect it once again. And we look at the daily, that is beautiful. So we see this nice trend upwards up into these highs, right? This level is very clearly respected. And now we're starting to reject. So sells is what I'm seeing already. The target is going to be the bottom, obviously. Probably partials around this level. Here, 1286. We can see partials at 1286. So where will we enter? Shoot, that is beautiful. I'm probably going to have to trade the euro, yen, as well as pound yen. But we have not made the lower low like we did in pound yen. So let's go to the 1 hour and look at the structure here. I'm going to mark past week's high. So I'm going to move that. And clearly, we have not really made the full bearish pressure. If you want, you could say, you know, here's a low, then there's a high, then there's a lower low. But I look at the overall market, and to me, this is the low, this is the high, and we have not made a lower low, and we have not made a lower high. So that gives us a good opportunity to wait and see either A, we break. Let me get my drawing tools. We can break, make a new lower low. We come up, make a lower high, potentially around this level right here. Right, which is also, if I drag that left, right, I hope you guys can see how that's lining up really well. I would love to see a lower high here, but I would like to see that after it already made the lower low. So we'll see what happens when market opens. It'd be really nice to see it break this 130.175 and then pull all the way back up to the 130.450 area and reject, because if you like those patterns, it would also be like a head and shoulders start of the deal. And the target is going to be a swing daily trade, just like pound yen. So a solid 250 pips, and you add that with the 300 pips on the pound yen, 550 pips, a lot of pips with the right lot size. It's good money right there. Good opportunities. So I'm definitely gonna be watching that. Very OSD. Very similar. Very, very similar to the pound USD chart. Again, that's because of the DXY indices. So again, we play those weekly levels. We see respect. These levels here, 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 a little bit of chop around there. It's the top of that weekly. And same thing, we're rejecting that again. This is a 2 week range. So how many pips is it from this week? So 120 or 210. Now it might take 2 weeks if we're selling. It might take 2 weeks or it might take one. I mean, it all depends. And if we're buying, the target's gonna be way up here, but let's look at the daily first. And see a nice pin bar. It was slightly bullish, but still a pin bar. And if we look left, we again just created another wick within this area. You see the tops of these bodies on the daily here. No candle closed above it. And same thing's happening again. We're not getting any closes above that, which leads me, just like the pound USD, it leads me to believe this might be selling. Again, it depends on the DXY, because that DXY like really strongly impacts these markets. Now, one thing I do see with this market is this pattern right here. So we see the push down, and this is sort of corrective structure. If you wanted, you could do 1, 2, 3, like the Wyckoff. However, if we're going to make this huge run up into these levels here, right? So follow my cursor, starting at the left, we go over. This level is respected very well. So if we're going to run up, I think this is going to be the first stop, and then maybe keep going from there. Who knows? But for now, I think what will happen is if we go back to the weekly and I mark the bottom of the body of this past week, which if you look left, also lines up with the tops of these. Now let's go back to, daily. What I could see here is a drop into the bottom of that weekly candle. And then if we are gonna run, then I think we're gonna run from there. And I could drag this left and go like that. And it would line up really well, but let's go to the 4H. We are seeing sell pressure. This is the low. This is a high. This is kind of the low. It's not really changed structure yet. Definitely not on the 1 hour. So same thing, just waiting right now. There's not really any immediate entry. Lots of rejection in here though. Let's see what happened last time we came in here. So you look at the structure, we came up to the top. And we made a new low, and then we made the lower high, which if I was looking at this trade or this market and I was looking to enter, I probably would have entered somewhere around this candle, around this area, which of course came back to entry 2 times, which is why it's very important that when you get in a trade, just stay in the trade. Trust your analysis, trust yourself, even if it goes and draw down, because you're probably right. I can easily say a vast majority of my losses over the past 5 years has not been from being wrong. It's been from being right and entering a trade and then watching it go and draw down and getting freaked out and then closing it and then watching it hit my take profit. It's the worst feeling in the world. And if you get a habit of doing that, it's really hard to break. So if you're starting now, when you get in the trade, before you press the button, fully accept everything, fully trust yourself, and tell yourself and be aware that you have to hold this until it hits your target. And then you'll see your results change if you're not doing that already. We see a spike in here, reject, spike, reject, and then huge liquidity spike, took out these highs and these highs, and then just absolutely dumped. So right now we don't have all that structure yet. There's no rush with this whatsoever. I think the best entry is going to be up into this area right here, this in this zone. We're at 1.818, essentially, right now. Excuse me. I think somewhere closer to like 1.19, like up in here, would be a better entry. I don't think it'll just drop right away. I think we're going to be able to come up here, play around up here. Sniper would be, you know, towards the top, like right up in here, right up in these wicks. And we can see it fall down to that weekly low. And then from here, I could definitely see buys coming into play, and then we blast past this level. So it all depends if we can come down here and hold this level. There is obviously the chance we could come down here, but I really don't think so with this pair. If we drag this left, we can also see if I move it slightly upwards, it doesn't line up exactly, but we do have this structure level right here that kind of lines up with the level we're looking at over here, which is the open of last week, essentially. So I think this next week, we come up here, we play within these wicks. Shoot, even if we wake above that one, that'd be sniper entry. If you're watching the 5-minute structure, when the 5-minute starts changing up there, you get in that entry. I said we hold it down here, and then we might see a huge push up into these, like 1.21 area. But that's for the weeks ahead, so let's just focus on right now. And right now, we're looking at potential selling from the upper side of the zone into last week's open, waiting and seeing what goes on from there. And then we got New Zealand dollar, CHF. Oh, I remember this. So this is a beautiful corrective structure on the weekly level. And I was actually looking at buying, I think I actually even did buy, I was just looking because it broke. I'm looking at this high, it broke these two highs, and I was expecting a pullback about halfway and then buy from there. But what happened was price came all the way back down into these lows on the daily, which I guess I was blind or something and didn't see that. Because once we hit that low, we just absolutely exploded. Now, New Zealand CHF typically doesn't move that much as comparing to pound pairs, but this thing moved 300 pips, and that is a lot of buy pressure. And currently, we are sitting at a resistance. So boom, boom, boom. So it's interesting to me. On the weekly level, I'm full bullish. I mean, I think we're gonna make our way. I can almost guarantee you we're gonna make our way up into these highs again. Right? That's just how the market flows. You know, you make a corrective structure, you fly up there. That being said, the fact that we're at that resistance, that lines up perfectly. Let's go to the 4-hour. So I look at this and I think overextended. Okay, typically it doesn't move. This pair does not move 300 pips without pulling back. This is not a pullback. So I would like to see this pullback. It's just determining where, you know, it's hard to judge. I don't think we're going to come all the way back down into this week low. I think we're actually going to do about a 50% retracement, which lines up with these structure levels. So we'll see what this looks like. So if we can retrace down here and then just explode up over the next few weeks, that'd be brilliant. So let's go to 4 hour. I swear that was like, all right, never mind. Let's go to 1 hour. So that is a respected level. It's not as clean right here, but it is clean here and here. And we are starting to see some rejection. And you might say, well, you saw rejection here. Was that at an important level? No, it was in the middle of nowhere. The rejection here is at a very important weekly and daily resistance. That's what's important. And I'm leaning towards a short for a pullback, but long term, I'm definitely bullish. I definitely think we're going to come up and hit these weekly highs up here, the top of this corrective structure. I mean, you look at that on the daily, and I could go like this. I could draw a little channel. Just that. Right, this right here, when price broke out, that's why I was looking to buy. I think I have my level like around here, like around this, the top of this candle and this doji or indecision candle. I had a level here marked and I was looking to buy there. However, we dumped and we grabbed a lot of liquidity here. There must have been a lot of orders and now we're absolutely flying. So I think we might get a slight pullback, at least to this level on the daily. That looks really good. I could see, you know, a few candles maybe this week, maybe the whole week it pulls down here slowly. And then following week, we just see another explosive move up into these levels right here. So we look left. So that's the next target, as I guess you could say. You could short this. This short is possible, especially with the 1 hour. Personally, I don't really trade this pair. And I am going to wait for the pullback and just buy. Because I'm way more bullish than I am bearish. There's chances of the seller here. There is good chances of this coming down. What is this? Like 80 pips? Yeah. However, since me, just personally, I would just wait for the buy. I mean, you could sell to buy. It's very, very possible. But I'm just going to wait out. There's better opportunities to get in right now, which is like the yen pairs and possible the USD pairs. And then just wait and see if we can actually get the respect from this level or whatever level price pulled back to. So totally patient, totally waiting. I mean, you could say, I mean, who knows, right? Price might only pull back into this level here before it starts moving up. So that's why I'm not really keen on shorting it. It is possible. It is at the resistance. We are seeing a little bit of the pressure, but I'll just like to wait. What's interesting too is you see this wick. So if I draw the top of this wick, people probably shorted right here, right? If we look at this wick creation, and then you see price started to dump right here, how it made this wick. So price or people probably started to short right there. And then guess what happened? The banks came in and said, nope, not yet. And pushed up and did not close, I guess. If you want, you can consider that closed above. but here, now it's more exact. Rejected. Grabbed some orders here. So, yes, I think the sell is valid. But, I mean, it's hard to predict the bottom here because this is a lot of buy pressure. So, I mean, is the bottom here? Is the bottom here like we saw earlier? Is it here? This level is sticking out to me. I've looked at this level multiple times since we've had this chart open. This would be brilliant. I mean, that would be a really nice sell, but, you know, 130 pips, that's good. That's a good sell, but it's like, where's the bottom actually going to be? So there's opportunity here. You know, maybe if we get the right price action, maybe you take it, but probably just going to wait for the buys. This would be awesome. This is a very clean level. Let's see if it extends to the left. If we pull it to the left, ever so slightly. Oh, wow. So it's really zoomed out right now. Let's see how it looks in the 4 hour. Yeah, that's a nice level right there. So boom, respect it here, 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 a little bit here, right here, here. We got a nice width from it. We have a little indecision there. We got the widths here. Honestly, I could definitely see price pulling back all the way down here now that we've discovered this. That is possible. Okay, that is very possible. And again, we're at that weekly resistance. So if I mark at the top of this, right, we can see the resistance. Very possible. Now I'm a little bit more open to short in it. That looks clean. And if we throw a fib on it, it's probably roughly half. I don't have the half marked up there, but yeah, that's possible for sure. And then buy from here and swing it all the way up here, like on the weekly level, like a couple weeks probably. Depends. I mean, this took 2 weeks. So that's 300 pips. So yeah, this buy from this level here could take 2 weeks also. Who knows? I guess we'll have to watch and see. So that covers that. I'm definitely paying attention to this one. I want to get in this. I hooked up a demo to this trading view because my broker doesn't link. And just for shits and giggles, I shorted this with massive lots, guys. Look at this. Entry is 152.1. So we're 30 pips in profit and $15 million in profit. I think that's 65,000 lots. I don't know. But if it hits target, I'm making 100. I'm not making anything, but it'll be 183 million, which is crazy. It just shows you the opportunity that we have here. I don't think anyone, any broker, or I don't think it's even possible to do a lot size that big, but even if you have a fraction of that, is tremendous. Very, very tremendous. So to wrap up, for me personally, I'm focusing on these two pairs only. I think we have really good opportunity here. We just gotta see, we gotta see that push down, that lower high on both of them. And then it's downhill from there in a good way, a good downhill. Maybe peak at crypto. Let's go to the weekly on Ripple. Beautiful. Push out of this accumulation zone. We stalled for 2 weeks. That's totally okay. I would love to see, or I guess this week closes right here. It'd be lit to see this week close, like more towards like in the 30s, like 130 something, and then next week push up. But who knows? Bitcoin, we did get a very solid 0.618 fib retracement. It's shown down here for a few months, and now we're starting to see that come up again. Similar to like right here, how we push up to 40 and then we pull back and then we just pull up and slight pull back and then up and then up. Right now we're doing that at just a larger scale. So 50,000 is a huge psychological level. And if you look left on my crosshair, you can see it's also a really good resistance, obviously, psych level. In my opinion, if we can clear this and get up into like the mid 50s, the mid to lower 50s, like close on the daily up there, not just like a wick, I think we will see 50 flip to a support instead of a resistance. It's trying. We first came back up there in late August and we haven't really broken down below, you know, mid upper 40s. However, we're starting to actually push up and close above that 50, which is good. It's good. Bitcoin has, I mean, now look at it. Bitcoin has the ability to just fly. So maybe we pull back. If we do pull back, I think we're going to like the 42, this level right here. However, I would never personally short Bitcoin in my life. I would never short it. If this daily can close higher, let me zoom in. If this daily can close higher than this one, and we get a big bull candle and we close at like 51 or 51,500, I think there's a pretty good chance we're going to start making our way back up to these highs, like 60 for now. And then we're going to have to do the same process here at 68,000. We break 60, I think we're going to 80. I forgot exactly how he came up with that. I think it was a fib extension instead of the retracement. That's about it. An interesting crypto to see is Solina. I don't know if I'm saying that right, but look at that weekly chart. October, the high was $1.80. And here we are, what's that, 10, 11 months later, we're at 140 bucks. We peaked at 150. It's a crazy opportunity, that's what I'm saying. So let me show you something. So if you go down here, let me zoom in, 4-hour chart. Go down here, right now we can see the candles clearly. Right, you're looking at this, November, right, December. If someone told you Solina's gonna go to like a couple hundred bucks, and you're like, okay, well, what does that look like on the chart? We go like this to zoom out, a couple hundred bucks. I mean, this is minuscule. It's non-existent. You look at price reaching 160, you're like, dude, no way. I mean, look at that. That doesn't even make sense. But look what happens. Now we're there. Same with Ethereum, Bitcoin, Litecoin. There's a few others I don't have on here. I'm forgetting the name now. like Ethereum, it's coming up towards a new all-time high, right? I mean, 15 months ago, this thing was $100. You look at these levels, you look at these prices, it's the same thing. Like if you said, oh, Ethereum is probably going to go to 4K in the next 12 months, you would zoom out and be like, dude, there's no way. I believe we are going to get the same opportunity here. You look at a couple hundred dollars, you got to zoom out just like the other ones, and that looks minuscule. I mean, you can't even tell, but once it starts going, the candles change a little bit. So it's very possible. Very, very possible. And we're ending soon. Been at it for a minute. Is Waldo in here still? Hey, I'm going to hop on a bike if you want to meet at the marina. Probably shortly after this. Well, that's it, guys. All right, cool. Yeah. Yeah, when this ends, give it like 20 minutes of Waldo, and then I'll hop on my bike. For the VIP guys, I will be sending all the analysis in there, of course, breakdowns for the people who didn't get to join. I'll send you guys these three and these two. I'll throw some in here for you guys. Well, hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you guys learned something. Hope you guys see what I'm seeing. And let's have another amazing week. Team, let's eat. Signals crushing it. Some weeks are more choppy than others, but overall, we stay up. So that's the most important thing. Do I need to stop?